Welcome to WeekdayChurch.com, our final episode of this first week of big picture thoughts in the political realm is about environmentalism. Does the Bible talk about that at all? Or really, do Christians not have to worry about that so much? And we just, know that it's all going to burn up in a fire at the end anyways, so just do what you need to do. Well, we're going to see what the Bible says about that as we continue through our lesson today. Heavenly Father, I do pray that we will honor and glorify you in the things that you've given us, whether they be the smaller things that you've given us that are personal to each of us, like talents and finances and family, or whether they be the enormous things that we all share, like this entire planet. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Billy Graham was asked a question that said this: should Christians be environmentalists? Well, after our first clip, we're going to get to see what Billy Graham's answer is about that, because I see that the church in North America, especially, is very divided on this issue. I'll see you right after the clip.
I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship. Let me be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to
Well, when Billy Graham was asked if Christians should be environmentalists, he says this: we don't worship the earth. Instead, we realize that God gave it to us, and we are accountable to him for how we use it. After creating Adam, the first man, the Bible says, the Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to work it and take care of it, in Genesis 2:15. God didn't tell him to exploit the world or treat it recklessly, but to watch over it and use it wisely, like a good ruler. We should seek the welfare of everything God entrusts to us, including the creation. And the Bible says in Proverbs 12:10, a righteous man cares for the needs of his animal. The Bible makes it very clear throughout the scriptures that this world was God's gift to us. But not only God's gift to us, it is our responsibility to take care of it, and to take care of it well. Christians, again, have often set up on politics on one side versus another. And in America, and even where I live here in Canada now, what I see is many of those who go to conservative churches also vote rather conservatively. It's not a total thing across the board, but it's pretty consistent. You know, and the reasons are because of the other things that we'll be talking about, like, well, normally it's the conservatives that are more fiscally responsible. Normally it's the conservatives that are against abortion. Normally it's the conservatives that are more for having churches have more rights and freedoms. And, you know, but you know what's funny is, it's also the conservatives, as you come to this issue, for instance, that normally are not so good about the environmental causes. And instead of saying, you know, we want our party to change, we just keep party solidarity. We don't cross that thin blue line. And we say, no, no, whatever they do must be okay. Just stick with your party. And if that's what they find unimportant, well, then you just find it unimportant too. We'll talk about this next week also as we talk about welfare and where that cross is there. But today is just going to be talking about it in regards of environmentalism. What's funny is Christians should be taking the lead in environmental causes, and for very different reasons than most of those in the Green Party do. It's not because this world is the only home we have. That's actually not true. The Bible even teaches us that there's much more than just this world, that in fact our eternal home is heaven, and that this world will pass away by fire one day, and that God will have to renew it. It's not that. It's not that this world is a god to us. It's no Gaia, Mother Gaia, or Mother Earth, or anything like that. It is because Father God has given us this planet and the responsibility and opportunity to take care of this great gift that he's given us. And from the very first man, that was part of who he was. From the very first woman, that was part of who she was. They were going to, together, take care of this world that God gave us. Now that, over all the billions of people on the planet, does not mean that they're all going to be farmers. But it does mean this, that there are ways that every one of us can make where we are better than when we came, or we can make it worse than when we came. And that's the kind of thing that I think you need to look at. And when we put this on a political statement, what you need to say is, well, maybe you're already in a party that needs to change in other ways. As we go into next week again, as we're going to talk about the abortion, if you're a liberal, then one of the things that you need to make clear, if you're a liberal or a Democrat, is, you know, I will not support you. I will not just smile and say it's okay because I like the other policies that you have when you are pro-killing babies. I can't go for that. But as a conservative or a Republican, what you need to say is, as long as you are for big business just totally tearing up things that cannot be replaced in many lifetimes, ruining the seas, ruining the drinking water, I'm not just going to smile and say, well, I agree with enough other things, so we'll just overlook that. No, we need to say we have a responsibility, not to just us, not to just the future generations, but to the God whose world this is and to the God who gave it to us, to say we will take care of what you've given us. Sure, there's generations coming after us that will appreciate it too, and they will also have the same responsibility. We must be Christian environmentalist. We must vote that way, and we must live that way in practical terms according to everything that God has given us as his gifts. Heavenly Father, may we be faithful to what you've given us. May we honor you through the planet that you've given us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you for joining us. Hope to see you again next week as we continue our political thought, but as we pull things a little closer to home. Hope you enjoy this last clip.
As the deer pants for the water, so my soul longs after you. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship you.
You alone.
You
my friend, and you are my brother, even though you are a king.
You're my friend, and you are my brother, even though you are a king. I love you more than any other, so much more than any.
Course again as the deer pants for the water.